Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how to use Microsoft Excel to create a bell curve. If you'd like to follow along with today's lesson, I'll put a link to this spreadsheet down below in the description so you can click on it and download it, open it up, and follow along and practice with me. Let's get started on how to create this bell curve in Microsoft Excel. You can see in today's example, we're going to be creating a bell curve in Microsoft Excel based on student marks. So these are just random numbers I put in, and these are just some names to connect with them. What I'd like to do before we get with putting in using our functions for mean, standard deviation, and normal distribution, I like to sort my data here from smallest to largest. So what I'm going to do is just select what I need to be sorted. Go up to sort right here and then sort smallest to largest. And when this prompts you, hit, make sure you expand the selection because I want the names to be connected also. So I hit sort, and that's the first step right here for me. I could have done this at a later point as well, but I just like to sort it to begin with. So we have this sorted smallest to largest. My next thing is going to be to find the mean. Now we have a function for mean, and that's going to be our average. With any of these functions that we're going to be using, we need to start with the equal sign. I'm going to start typing in average, and you can see it comes up right here. So I'm going to select this. What do I need to select? Well, I need to select my range here of all my different marks, and I'm just going to hit enter. At this point, I don't want to have all these decimal places, so I'm just going to make it a whole number here, round it up. Here we can see to 66. So that's the first step, is finding out the mean for this data set. The next thing is going to be standard deviation, and we have a function for that as well. So I'm going to start with my equals, and if I just put in ST, you can see D. We have two different ones we could possibly use. I'm going to be using the STDEV.P because I know my data set is complete. This is all the marks that I have. If it wasn't complete, if it was just a sample, you would use the next one down here, the .S. So I'm using .P. And again, just like average, all I have to do is select what I want to apply the standard deviation to. Hit enter, and again, I'm going to just round this up so it should turn to 21, just like that. So I have my mean, my standard deviation. This allows me to use the function for normal distribution now. So if I go to this cell right here, and if I just put my equals in, and I start typing normal, this is going to be it right here. So this norm.dist, I'm going to select this one. Now I'm going to walk you through all the different arguments in this using this function. So when it says X on the first one, what you need to do is select the first mark over here. So it's going to be this right here. We need to put a comma after, and it says select the mean. Well, we did the mean. It's right here. So that's D2, and I'm going to put a comma, and what's going to be the next thing? Standard deviation. So I still have one last thing to do. We have an option here of true or false. So it's going to be false for us, probability mass function. You can see there's cumulative distribution function, but we're going to be picking this one right here. So I'm selecting that one and my bracket, hit enter, and I get my first one right through here. So I do need to copy this down. And I want to point out, I could have done this before, we need to use F4 or to put the dollar signs around a couple of different things. Because if I copy this down, I need these ones locked in place. So I could double click on this or go up into the formula bar up here. And what I'm going to do is go just click in D2 here, and I'm going to use F4, so function F4. On this one, so I just hit the wrong key here. I'm just gonna click on here again and function F4, and I put the dollar signs around those ones, and I need to on standard deviation as well. So I'm gonna use my function F4, and just like that. So, and just hit enter. Nothing really changed here, the number, but what it's gonna do now, I'm gonna just double click on this little square in the corner, or I could drag down, but I'll just double click. it fills this all the way down. And notice if we look at our distribution already, we have our first number and last number being very similar. So it looks like it will be a nice bell curve. This is the point that we're at where we can actually add our bell curve in a chart to Microsoft Excel. So Microsoft Excel makes it really easy now to create a bell curve using a scattered chart. And how we do this is the first thing I'm going to do right now is actually select what I want to chart or graph. So this is going to be the information right through here. I'm going to go up to Insert. And it's going to be scatter chart that we're using. And it's this one right here. I'm going to show you a couple of different ways you can get to it. So you can see that there's scatter charts here. If I go to recommended right here, this is going to be the one we're going to be using this scatter. But if I go to all charts, if we take a look, we have the XY scatter right through here. And I can pick probably smooth lines is what I'd want. So I'm selecting this and it gives me kind of an example of what it would be. So I'm going to go ahead and hit OK on this and I get my chart. At this point, we can go through and we can format our chart. So if you wanted it looking a little different, we can apply different designs that are already created. So in the intro, I had this one. So I can select very quickly to make those changes. I can start changing, customizing this chart. So if I was just going to call this bell curve, just like this, whereas an example, I can go through and change colors and everything. But I have a whole different video about using charts in Microsoft Excel, and I'll put a link to that in below and up in the card above. But you can see the bell curve in this case looks nicely distributed from the class. I do want to point out, though, it's not a perfect bell curve, and that's because that the data sets of the students' marks, it's not normally distributed. So the mean, median, mode of the data set aren't the same on this. And you can see also, if I go ahead and make a change to one of these marks, so if I was going to change it to 17, you can start to see how the distribution isn't quite the same on this one. But I'm just going to go back. Now, this format, as I said before, you can go through and apply this to other information. You just need to have your data set to work from. And remember, when you're doing the standard deviation, whether it be from the complete set or just a sample on this. So I hope you like this, how to create a bell curve in Microsoft Excel. Let me know if this has worked for you, if you want to learn more about graphing or Excel. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next week with more tech tips and tutorials.